Day 1.
Okay, if you can integrate this today, then you will be good for the day. Yeah, let's go ahead and add 1 to here, and then we get 3, and then we divide it by the new power, so we have 1/3. So the answer is 1/3 x to the 3rd power, and then don't forget the plus e. That's it.
Day 2.
Today's topic is called the u-substitution, and here's the example. We are going to integrate x times e to the x squared power. How do we do it? Pay attention to the inner function. We have x squared, put that to be u, and then differentiate both sides. We will have du equals 2x dx. And we see that we have x dx right here, but we need to have the 2 so that we can get the du. So that's come here and multiply by a 2. But of course, we will have to divide that right away as well, so that we don't change anything, yeah? And we will just get 1/2 integral. The 2x dx is the du. We can put that right here. And then we have e, and the x squared is the u. So we're just integrating e to the u in the u world, and the answer for that is just e to the u. And then, of course, we still have that 1/2 right here, and then e to the u. U is x squared. Done, huh? After we put on the plus c. That's it.
Day 3.
Today's topic is called integration by parts, and we'll use the DI format for it. This is the integral of the day. We are integrating x squared times e to the x. So how do we do it? We'll put on the D and I first. D stands for differentiating, and I stands for integrating. And then also on the side, just put down some plus or minus just to get ready. We will differentiate x squared because if we keep going, you see 2x and then 2 and then 0. If you see 0 in the D column, you can stop. And then we'll just integrate e to the x. You can integrate this as many times as you want. It's always going to be e to the x. And do this, this, and that. And that will pretty much give you the answer. So first, we get positive x squared times e to the x. And then minus 2x times e to the x. And lastly, plus 2 times e to the x. And we are done after the plus c.
Day 4.
Today's topic is called trig sub, and we are going to integrate square root of 1 plus x squared. And the idea is to utilize some trig identities to help us simplify this. Because it has two terms, how can we combine to just one and then it's a perfect square? Have a look. We know that 1 minus sine squared theta, this right here gives us cosine squared theta, because that's just a Pythagorean identity. We know sine squared plus cosine squared is equal to 1, and we just rearrange it. And from here, we can also derive the other ones. For example, we can also say if we have secant squared theta minus 1, this actually gives us tangent squared theta. And from here, we can also derive another one. For example, if I move the one to the other side, we can say 1 plus tangent squared theta will give us secant squared theta. And these are the three main ones. As you can see, we have 1 plus something squared, 1 plus something squared, and here we only end up with one term, squared. Aha, that's the idea, huh? So I'm just going to start by saying let x be tangent theta, and then do the usual business. Here we have the dx, so go ahead, differentiate both sides. Dx equals, what's the derivative of tangent theta?
Is it there?
Yeah, it's secant squared theta d theta. Now, let's put this back here. We will get the integral square root 1 plus dx is tangent, and then we have the squared, and then the dx is that, so we have secant squared theta d theta. So they are multiplying like this. And now if you look at this, this is really just secant squared. So we have that. And then of course, we still have the square root. And this and that cancel, so we just get secant theta. But wait, don't we need the absolute value? Yes, right? But it's okay, let me just tell you we don't need to here. Just don't worry about it. I know that's bad teaching, but whatever. Anyway, this is just secant theta times another secant theta. We are really just looking at the integral of secant third power theta d theta. And if you did the homework already, you will know the answer for this right here is 1/2 secant theta times tangent theta plus 1 half ln absolute value secant theta plus tangent theta. Now, we are going to go back to the x world, and to do so, look at here. We know tangent theta equals x, which is x over 1. Go ahead and draw the right triangle. Here is the right angle, and here's the angle theta. And then for tangent, we know that's opposite over adjacent, so we have x over 1 like this. And for the hypotenuse, is you first open the square root, and you do this squared plus the other side squared. So from here, we know what secant theta is. So now let's go back here. We have 1 half. Secant is hypotenuse over adjacent. So it's just square root of 1 plus x squared. And then for tangent theta, it's just x over 1, just x. And then let's just write down the rest. 1 half ln absolute value. Actually, we don't need the absolute value because you will see secant is square root of 1 plus x squared. And then we add tangent is x. This is always positive, so we just need a parenthesis. Done.
Day 5.
Today, I will show you guys how to do partial fraction decomposition to break down this into smaller fractions that we can actually integrate. Have a look. Let me write down the top right here, 2x plus 1 over. For the bottom, we can actually factor it, right? So let's go ahead and factor it. We get x minus 2 times x minus 1. Now, we can break this down into two smaller fractions. The first one will have x minus 2 on the bottom. And for the second one, we will have the x minus 1 on the bottom. Notice both of them are linear, meaning we have x to the first degree. So that means the top will give us no degree. So it's degree 0. It's just a constant. Constant A and constant B. Why? Because if you have the same degree, let's say if you say ax plus b, then you can do long division, you can like break it down, right? So it's just constants. All right, how do we find a? Let's use the so-called Kafra method. Let me show you. A is going to be easy, you will see. On the bottom, we have x minus 2. We go back to the original and cover it up, cover up the x minus 2. And you ask yourself, x minus 2, how can it be 0? X has to be 2, right? Yeah. So we put x to be 2, and we plug that into here and here. Not here, because we covered it already. So on the top, we have 2 times 2, and then plus 1 over this 2 here, and then minus 1. On the top, I believe we get 5. On the bottom, I believe we get 1. And I believe 5 divided by 1 is equal to 5. So a is equal to 5. Now, don't worry, let's practice with b. B, we can also do cover up. We have x minus 1. Come here, cover it up. X is equal to 1. And we plug into here and here. So we have 2 times 1 plus 1 over 1 minus 2. Work this out, we get b negative 3. So now we can come here and then just write down. We have the integral. This fraction is just this, right? And now, 5 over this, we get linear, right? This is linear, so it's natural log. So we have 5 times the natural log absolute value, yeah? And then the inside is x minus 2. And then minus 3 times, same thing, natural log absolute value x minus 1 plus c. And that's it, that's the answer, yeah? Hey, I know you like calculus, because otherwise you wouldn't watch this video, right? And now, if you want to learn more calculus, then one great place for you to continue is our sponsor today, Brilliant.org. Brilliant is an online learning platform with thousands of interactive lessons in math, science, and computer science. And of course, let's take a look at their calculus lessons. You see, not only they will teach you all the integration techniques, but also the lessons are all interactive, so you are not just going to be memorizing the formulas. With cool animations and storytellings, you can really enjoy learning the calculus concepts and applications. And as a calculus teacher, students often ask me how they can learn calculus on their own in a fun way, and I will always recommend Brilliant to them. And right now, you can even try Brilliant for 30 days free. So go ahead and check them out. Use the link in the description, brilliant.org/blackpenredpen, so that you can get 20% off discount. I want to thank Brilliant for sponsoring this video. I also want to thank you for checking them out.